I spy with my little eye.
Episode 10 of Quaker TV. We have a great show for you today.
On today's show, we look at the importance of physical fitness and nutrition, how bathroom privileges are being abused here in SHS, and discuss the importance of career exploration and sit down with our resident technology department whiz here at SHS.
All that and more on episode 10 of Quaker TV, and it all starts now.
Welcome back to Quaker TV. I'm Antonio.
And I'm Aaliyah, and here are your announcements for Friday, December 7th.
Reminder to CCP students taking classes in spring 2024 to email or turn in your Kent and or YSU schedule and book list to Mrs. Altenhoff.
Mr. Samu is pleased to announce the spring musical, Grease. The auditions are open through 9th through 12th grade students, and the audition date is Wednesday, December 13th at 6 p.m. in the choir room. There will be a sign-up sheet for a time, and please sign up outside of the choir room door. Please bring a portion of a song to sing with you, and you may sing something from Grease if you wish. If we need you to read for a particular part, we will ask you to come back on Thursday, December 14th at 6 p.m. to read. The show will be presented on March 22nd, 23rd, and 24th.
And now for a quick reminder on the importance of staying fit and eating right. Our own Rylee Hutton will show you this, how simple choices in physical activity and nutrition can lead to a healthier and happier you. Let's take a look.
In a world that's constantly moving, where the demands of life can sometimes feel overwhelming, it's easy to overlook one of the most fundamental aspects of our well-being, our physical health. Today, we'll explore why physical fitness and nutrition are not just choices, but essential components of a fulfilling and balanced life. A well-balanced diet provides the nutrients your body needs to function, from vitamins and minerals to proteins and carbohydrates. It's not just about counting calories, it's about nourishing your body with the right ingredients to promote vitality and longevity. But it's not only about what you eat, it's also about how you move. Physical fitness isn't just a matter of appearance, it's about embracing a lifestyle that enhances every aspect of your life. Regular exercise has been linked to improved mood, reduce stress, and enhance cognitive function. It's a natural remedy for the presence of daily life, releasing endorphins and boost your mood and leave you feeling energized. So, as you embark on your path to a healthier lifestyle, remember, physical fitness and nutrition are not just activities, they are keys to unlocking your full potential and maintaining a healthy lifestyle.
Pep Club is selling handmade Quaker Christmas ornaments for $5. See Mrs. Deborah in the main office to purchase one.
Monday, December 11th at 8:30 a.m. in the Learning Commons, we will host an ASVAB. The ASVAB is for any 11th and 12th graders who are interested in career exploration.
Ever wondered how to turn your fun passions into a career? Our Keegan Mayhew created a PSA to guide you on a journey of career exploration. Discover the keys to finding a fulfilling path that aligns you with your interests and strengths. Here's what he had to say.
What do you want to do when you grow up? Probably go to NFL.
I was thinking about going to welding.
Teach.
Welcome to this week's QTV PSA. My name is Keegan, and we're just going to be doing a quick little talk over career exploration. Some people know what they want to do with their lives from the second an event happens. Other people take some time to learn. Some people don't figure out what they want to do until they're in college. Some of the teachers here at Salem knew exactly what they wanted to do from the moment they were in high school or the moment they graduated.
So after I graduated high school, I wanted to be a teacher.
Teach.
I knew right away I wanted to be a teacher.
Everything, like, you make one choice and maybe you don't like it. College has many different options, but then there are also options of not going to college. You can go into a career, or you can go into the workforce.
Or military. I know personally myself, I thought I was going to go into the military for my first 2.5, maybe even 3 years of high school. Don't let things get to your head. Don't feel forced to go into a career field because that's what your parents want you to do or that's what you're expected to be.
Or if you want to be 30,000 feet in the air, in a pilot, go for it. Pursue what you want to do. It's going to be fun.
When I graduated, I wanted to get into either religion, philosophy, or politics, and there's not very many opportunities to make money in those fields outside of teaching, so I kind of found a nice little way to fulfill my interest.
And it's not always about a pursuit of money. Money is frivolous. Don't feel trapped by little town Salem, Ohio. Go out there. There is so much more to the world than you think. In the end, do what you want to do. Be happy with yourself. You are meant to be something more.
Why are you just filming me?
He's a character.
That's an undisclosed information.
You know, like the Meyer hot dogs? I'm gonna be their logo guy.
Teach.
What do you want to do after you graduate?
I want to be Ice Spice.
Like, Hillsap.
Holding strawberry milk.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
December 11th through 15th is Don't Be a Grinch Week. If you get caught being kind, you get a candy cane. The daily themes are Monday, Ugly Sweater Day, wear an ugly sweater and compliment someone on their fun attire.
Tuesday, Festive Hat Day, wear your favorite festive hat and tip your hat to say hello to someone new.
Wednesday is PJ Day, wear your PJs today and perform a kind gesture for someone in need.
Thursday, Red versus Green, wear red or green and help a teacher, staff member in red or hold the door for someone in green.
Friday is Quaker Crazy Christmas, show your school spirit and smile at someone in the hallway.
An important issue here at SHS is that affects the daily experiences of students in our building is bathroom abuse. Our own Lance Bailey created a public service announcement shedding light on the misuse of bathroom privileges. Let's take a look.
What's up, SHS? This is Mr. DeBar, and today we're going to talk about bathroom privilege abuse. Over the past few years, students have been leaving class an awful lot, mostly to use the bathroom. However, they're not really using the bathroom. Whether it's just walking around the halls or using the bathroom as a lounge, bathroom passes are being abused. For example, there's a student in this building who has created 115 passes this year, totaling 13 hours and 47 minutes out of the classroom. What could you possibly be doing in a bathroom for 13 hours? Another student here has created 172 passes this year. We've only been in school 63 days, meaning he has used his max amount of passes every day we have been in school. The pure abuse of the restroom is embarrassing and needs cleaned up. How about we go to class and stay in class for a change? Let's learn something new today. Good luck, be safe, and remember, go Quakes.
The junior high food drive will run from now through December 8th. The first period class that brings in the most items per student will win a Dunkin' Donuts breakfast Friday, December 15th. In addition, if we reach our school goal of 2,000 items, the entire junior high will be treated to a Christmas movie in the auditorium on the last day of school before Christmas break. Bring in those cans, Quakers.
There always seems to be issues with technology. Here at SHS, our own Joe Gerberry is the one responsible for making sure everything runs smoothly. Our own Carson Rhodes sat down with him to get a view of his daily activities.
Who are you and what do you do?
My name is Joe Gerberry and I'm the Assistant Tech Director here for Salem City Schools.
How long have you been doing this?
I've been with the district, I think this is my eighth year. This is the, I think, third year we've had one or just me stationed up here at the high school for most of the day.
What does a typical day look like for you?
I come into this building around 7:30 in the morning. I'm here until at least 10:30. That's if no other buildings need me. Around then, I try to get whatever tickets I have, and then I come back. I eat my lunch, and I come back around 6 period, and I'm here till the end of the day.
What is the most frustrating part of your job?
Probably the the lack of respect that the students have for the technology. We have a lot of kids that, you know, don't care about the Chromebooks themselves, don't care about returning chargers and stuff. We have people that actually need them, and there's people that have probably three or four chargers at home. Or, you know, I see broken Chromebooks every day of screens and touchpads and water damage and everything, so.
What is the worst damaged Chromebook you've ever seen?
That'd be a student a couple years ago brought it in here, and he said that it was, quote, under his bed, and that a ashtray might have fallen on it. The keys were all ripped off, the screen was destroyed and not even in the Chromebook. Like, there's no way that that's what happened. It was really bad. I literally picked it up. I was like, all right, we're gonna go see Mr. McLaughlin, and took him right there. And yeah, he didn't have a Chromebook the rest of the time.
That's all the announcements for episode 10 of Quaker TV. I'm Antonio.
And I'm Aaliyah. Have a great weekend, Quakes.